former President Donald Trump has dodged a second assassination attempt. The Secret Service firing shots after a man was spotted allegedly pointing an AK-47 at the presidential candidate.
Let's go to 9's US correspondent Alice Matrowski for more now. Ali, good morning. Someone was arrested in a nearby county.
Yeah, Sarah Carl, good morning to you. We don't know the suspect's name, but the Martin County Sheriff says that he was calm, that he complied with officers and had an overall calm demeanour when they pulled him over. And in fact, they pulled him over only a few kilometres up from Trump National Golf Course where this unfolded today. Donald Trump was between holes 5 and 6 out on the golf course. His Secret Service teams were around him. One of the teams was a couple of holes ahead, guys, and they spotted the end of a rifle sticking out of the bushes. And the Secret Service chose to engage. That suspect fled and he was arrested within a couple of kilometres.
We were able to get a hit on that vehicle on I-95 as it was headed into Martin County. We got a hold of Martin County Sheriff's Office, alerted them, and they spotted the vehicle and pulled it over and detained the guy.
Pretty remarkable that it was a witness that had spotted the suspect flee from the scene, and that witness had the presence of mind, guys, to take a photo of the vehicle and the license plate. That is what led to the suspect's quick capture. Also found at the scene a little later by the Secret Service teams were two backpacks and an AK-47 with a scope. That scope is interesting because it means that it was far more accurate and potentially could have even hit Donald Trump from the distance that it was currently at. And so here we are today, the president, the former president, a second assassination attempt on his life, though thankfully Donald Trump is safe and unharmed, guys.
Ali, thank you. Let's bring in former White House advisor Laura Schwartz now. Laura, good to see you this morning. So I know it's early days, but do we know whether this was a targeted attack?
No, we don't know that. And we also don't know if the Secret Service had spotted the gunman with the AK-47 style rifle before that gunman shot. So there were shots exchanged, but we don't know from which gun. And obviously the exact location. Right now, that golf course is locked down. It is a crime scene. Mm. And so we're going to hear shortly, possibly, you know, some new information. But I think they're gathering it themselves.
Mm. Look, some presidents and ex-presidents are more active than others. He certainly gets out there, doesn't he? Bill Clinton was another. Security around places like these golf courses would not be easy.
No, that's true. I used to be, of course, during my 8 years with President Clinton, on the staff rotation to go golfing with President Clinton. Now, I wasn't golfing on the golf course. Mm-hmm. I was in what we created as like a staff office at the golf course with the military aide, who, of course, has the nuclear codes, you name it, that always goes with the sitting president. And I would be there so that if any late breaking news or something came in from overseas or domestically, I could quickly brief the president and then, you know, decide on a situation or a move. The Secret Service has advanced people at the golf course before they arrive. And you've got Secret Service kind of in a golf cart motorcade, if you will, with the president. You also have golf carts with Secret Service going up ahead, one hole, two hole, looking at the sight lines, looking at that area on the fairway. And really, whether you own the golf course or not, it's tough to keep this secured. President Clinton often golfed on military installations in Washington, D.C. And when he's been traveling, President Obama often golfed at the military installation Pearl Harbor base in Hawaii, because there are fully secured golf courses in that way. But it's certainly hard to secure that larger space when you don't have the support of military around.
I mean, I guess it's, Laura, particularly concerning at the moment, given it's 2 months since the assassination attempt in Pennsylvania. How is security not airtight right now?
Well, that's a good question, Sarah, and I think they'll be asking themselves that, and they'll be grilled once again by members of Congress on that as well. You know, they put him into indoor rallies after what happened in Pennsylvania happened. Then they allowed him to do an outdoor rally, a couple of them, but they cover him with bulletproof glass, kind of almost like a little box, a little bubble of bulletproof glass. You can't just assume that something like a golf course isn't a target. Now, oftentimes, golfing is what we call an OTR, an off-the-record movement, where it is not publicized, people are not aware, and therefore they can't plan for some sort of attack, like we saw in Pennsylvania, where the shooter knew the sight lines from the building and he had it pre-planned. But here's the deal. The people in West Palm Beach in that area, anyone from around the world knows that he goes there a lot and he golfs there a lot. So you could be standing by and just waiting for that one day where you see the motorcade arrive. It's noticeable. You're going to know that he's there. Maybe that's your day to take your shot. It's you know, this person's in custody, so they're going to get information. You know, so this is all speculative there. But, you know, he frequents it. And the Secret Service, again, you can only secure something that large to a certain degree. That's why you have the advanced golf carts ahead and stragglers behind.
Look, no one wants to see this happen, but the Trump camp will galvanize it in their own way, I'm sure, moving forward.
Yes.
Laura, thank you so much. Let's bring in former CIA operative Bob Baer. Bob, good morning to you. How did you see it this morning?
Well, it looks like an assassination attempt. It's still early. And there's no reason there should be gunfire on a golf course. The FBI is treating it as an assassination attempt. And what worries me is so many experts are predicting political violence running up to this election and afterwards. Two assassination attempts on Trump seems to bear that out.
And I guess in some parts it's been encouraged. What is the fallout from a warning like that on the streets?
Well, it seems to be getting worse. You know, you combine the internet with people who believe in wild conspiracy theories and the availability of weapons in this country. Basically, anybody could obtain an assault rifle. You know, I always expect, you know, the worst and hope for the better.
So the suspect, as you say, was carrying an AK-style rifle, but it's unclear whether they got a clear shot at the former president. I guess he doesn't make it easy for Secret Service. He is out there a fair bit. Is it that easy to get that close to a president?
West Palm Beach, yes. That golf club is ultimately unpredictable. He's out so much in the public. He has security equivalent of the president, but nonetheless, his residence at West Palm Beach is, like I just said, not defensible.
So this sort of thing kind of galvanizes the Trump camp and followers as well. It can be, in a way, utilized in his campaign to an extent. How dangerous is that, do you think?
Well, he's portraying himself as a victim, and he is in a sense, and they're portraying the lapses in security as the fault of the federal government, that he's not being protected like everybody else. It's this belief in the deep state, and that the system is against his voters. And this is being repeated over and over again and believed more and more. And the partisan divisions in this country are getting wider and wider. That's obvious and it's not disputable.
There were some serious breaches on July 13. I don't think anyone disputes that.
It was sheer incompetence. I mean, the overlook on any campaign rally should be covered, and it wasn't. It was incompetence on the part of the Secret Service, no doubt about it. I don't know that they've gotten any better, but let's hope they have, because if Trump were to be assassinated, I guarantee you this country would break out in widespread violence.
That's an ominous warning. You're saying, Bob, that it's a powder keg?
Absolutely.
So the next few weeks and months?
Let's wait and see. Even if Trump loses the election, he stated that he will have been cheated, and there are people that believe that. I've got flags all around where I live up saying Trump was cheated in 2020, and people without any evidence believe this.
All right, Bob. Good to talk to you. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.